already here. That's why I wouldn't like to explain where we are now. And the Kazan Federal University was founded in 1804 by the decree of the Emperor of Russia, Alexander I. You can see the portrait of him here. It was only 28 years old for the Emperor when he signed the decree about the Kazan University. The goal for the establishment of the Kazan University was to make some bridge between the culture of the East and the West. And the area of responsibility at that time, I would like to say that at that time, the all Russia was divided into some area, and the education area of responsibility for the Kazan Federal University has spread it from Volga River till far east, till Vladivostok. All this region was under supervision of the Kazan Federal University. Here you can see the first decree of the Alexander I about the establishment of Kazan University. So now there are a lot of rankings of universities, and you know that how we can calculate the ranking of university. The most universities are proud by the Nobel Prize winners, by budget, by some other things. But if the rankings was based on the most cited students of the university, the Kazan University was the first in the world. Because we have two very famous students, Vladimir Lenin and Leo Tolstoy, who were the students of Kazan University. And nobody can say me that they are not most cited people in the world. Okay, but nevertheless, we are very proud by the Nobel Prize winners who worked in Kazan University during the Second World War, when all academician institutes were evacuated from the Moscow to Kazan. And you will see just the hall behind these doors, and it was a sleeping place for the academician at that time. And the most academician, very famous, worked in Kazan Federal University at that time. Just a few words about the hierarchy of universities in Russia, just to explain where we are now. Just on the top, we have two leading national universities. This is the Moscow University and St. Petersburg University. Underneath, we have 10 federal universities. And the Kazan University was founded in 2010. On the base of the Kazan State University, by the merging of five different institutes, mostly the humanitarian institutes for the economy, for the pedagogical science, and so on. And now we are one of the leading federal universities, one of the biggest universities, and you can see our numbers here. I would like to short my speech because of time, and just in Kazan campus we have more than 23,000 students, and in total in Kazan University we have more than 43,000 students. We have a lot of new research laboratories. For the last 3-4 years we made the big jumps in the rankings, and you see so now our positions in the rankings in the different system. When we became the federal university, we were a little bit frustrated. Why? Because we should serve like the federal university. It means that we are responsible for the science and for the education and the big Volga region. So we have to think about the teachers for the music, teachers for the kindergarten, for everything. But in order to be competitive in the world rankings, we have to be focused in some scientific directions, because it's absolutely impossible task to be competitive in the all fields of science. That's why we have chosen five priority areas of our development, and one of them, this is the advanced materials, which is mostly presented in the Institute of Physics. But the all these priority areas are covered by the scientists from the Institute of Physics. And it is very hard task for me now just to make some classifications, some distributions, who are working in which field, because we have the unique facilities. And when we started our program for the Federal University, we invented something new. We created the system of the open laboratories, the open labs. What does it mean? We just creating some infrastructure, we creating the new laboratories with new equipment, and we are inviting the scientists from the world to come to Kazan and work in these laboratories. We give equipment, we give some laboratories, we give living facilities for them. Please come to Kazan University to work with our young researchers, with our PhD students, in order to increase our positions in the science and everywhere. So that's why, for example, we started the new program for the biomedicine, because it is not traditional for the universities in Russia. Just in the beginning, when the Kazan University was founded by the Emperor Alexander the First, so it was the medical faculty. But during the Soviet Union times, the medical faculty have been separated from the classical universities, and the new medical institutes have been organized in many, many cities. But 3-4 years ago, we decided to return our positions in the medical science, and we just create again the new institute, the Institute for the Fundamental Medicine and Biology, where we are looking for the new fundamental medicine results, for the new translational medicine results, and so on. And of course, the Institute of Physics is participating in this program very much. Here you can see the core academic subdivisions at Kazan Federal Universities. Here you can see the physics, mathematics, and the IT, natural science, the Institute for the Fundamental Medicine and Biology, as I have mentioned already. We have very famous Institute of Chemistry, and I have to say that all organic chemistry was born in Kazan University, and you will have the possibility to see some examples of this in our museum. We have a rather big part of our universities in the humanities, social science, and economics. Of course, I have no time to speak a lot about all institutes. I would like to just mention a little bit that this year we started a new program in the framework of the program 500. So this is a Russian program for the promotion of the Russian universities to the top 100 universities in the world. And we have created some new strategic academic units, the drivers of our growth. And in all these academic units, the Institute of Physics is participating too much. And what is the most interesting thing, that we try to create in our university the unique infrastructure which allows us to merge science, education, and transfer of scientific results into economies to everywhere. For example, in order to transfer our results in the fundamental medicine, we have our own clinics. So we are only one university in Russia which has their own clinics for the 900 beds. And also we are looking for the other facilities in order to make the very successful transfer of the scientific knowledge and our results into real practice. What about the Institute of Physics? The Institute of Physics is one of the biggest institutes in Kazan Federal University. Here you can see some numbers, some figures. And we have, for example, three observatories, one in the suburb of Kazan, one another one in the North Caucasus, and the third one in Antalya, Turkey. We have 57 full professors, and you can see the numbers. And you can understand that, of course, I can say a lot of words about every department, but it will take too long time. That's why, please forgive me my colleagues in Kazan Federal University that I cannot mention for everything, and I will try to give the very brief overview of the physics in Kazan University. Since the foundation of Kazan University, Department of Physics was one of the first three departments established in Kazan University. And when the Lobachevsky became the rector of Kazan Federal University, he was the head of the Department of Theoretical Experimental Physics. Lobachevsky is a very famous Russian geometer who invented for the first time non-Euclidean geometry here in Kazan. And he was served like the rector of the university for the 27 years. And now we are sitting in the building which was built by the scheme and under supervision of Professor Lobachevsky. And another very famous person, this is Professor Simonov, who together with Bellingshausen and Lazar discovered Antarctica in 1820. And his historical achievement for the Kazan University was established astronomical observatory, one of the best in Europe. I would like to mention about the history. Of course, this is Professor Galgamer, who was a student of Professor Staletov. His field of interest was the meteorology, electromagnetic theory of light, and he was the rector of Kazan University just before the Great October Revolution. And the Professor Ulyanin, please do not miss with Ulyanov, so this is just different names, absolutely different names. He was interested too much in the terrestrial magnetism, and he was the director of Geophysical Observatory at Kazan University. And the most important pulse for the development of the physics in Kazan University got from the work of Zavoyski, who in 1944 discovered the phenomenon of electron paramagnetic resonance here in Kazan University. It was for the first time for the observation of the magnetic resonance in condensed matter physics. And after that, it was found the nuclear magnetic resonance, and the people got the Nobel Prize for the nuclear magnetic resonance. Zavoyski never got prize for the electron paramagnetic resonance discovery. And after some time working in Kazan University, he moved to Moscow in order to participate in the atomic project of Soviet Union. But the topics of magnetic resonance was the main topic of investigations in Kazan University for the very, very long time. And the scientific school, which was created by the Professor Altshuler, who was a student of Professor Tam, and he, for the first time, predicted and calculated the right sign and value of the magnetic moment of neutron. And he predicted the phenomenon of acoustic paramagnetic resonance, and his discovery laid the foundations of a new scientific field, quantum acoustics. Today, the structure of the Institute of Physics, like you can see, we have four divisions: physics divisions, radio physics division, pedagogical division, and astrophysics division. But we are working very close, and some people from different divisions are participating in some scientific research in the many multidisciplinary projects. And during the history, for example, 10 years ago, it was a program for the leading scientific school in Russia, and we got five scientific schools for the Institute of Physics, and one of them was led by the Professor Kachelaev, who was a student of Professor Altshuler, and it was a school for the resonant investigations of the condensed matter in condensed matter physics. Today, officially, we have three big fields of investigations, research areas. You can see here this area, and of course, it is just some umbrella, not more, because the people are working very actively in the different field of physics. What is the uniqueness of our university? Our characteristic feature, this is an integrative approach. We have created the unique infrastructure which allows us start from the computer design of new materials. We can synthesize these materials in our few laboratories for the crystal growth, for the thin film preparation and so on. After that, we have very good facilities for the characterization of these new materials. So we can provide the whole cycle of the scientific investigations just from idea how we can create new materials up to the creation of these new substances in order to be involved to our technique and so on. So I will skip this one. Of course, I would like to mention about few center for excellence which we created last years in our universities. One of them, this is, of course, the International Center of Magnetic Resonance. For the condensed matter physics, there are investigations in the spin superfluidity of condensed matters. So this is a new substances, new technologies for the superconducting devices and so on. We have the very good equipment for the magnetic resonance investigations in the different, absolute different range of the frequencies, starting from the EPR to NMR and to the optics. I cannot tell now about the all equipment. Just one international laboratory for the spin superfluidity in condensed matter I would like to mention here. So the physics of magnetic ordinary coherent states are studied in this lab. So another center of excellence, this is the Center for Quantum Technologies. So this is actually international center because I would like to show you our connections with the different centers in the world, in Japan, in Taiwan, in Austria, in Finland. So we are working together. It's really international project. And despite we exist only 4 years in our university, we already got very interesting results. For example, we predicted for the first time the high TC superconductors in the percolated graphite. So some very interesting things for the new quantum devices based on the electron floating on the superfluid helium and so on. So I have no time to mention about all of them. We have only one joint research laboratory between RIKEN and KFU. So it was the president of RIKEN, Professor Nayori, who opened this laboratory in Kazan 5 years ago. In the framework of this laboratory, we are providing some studies in the synthesis analysis of the thin film structures. The team leader of this professor, Tagirov, we have very good equipment for the vacuum deposition of the ultra-thin film systems. We have femtosecond laser physics in the framework of this, led by the director of Institute of Physics, Professor Nikitin, with some equipment you can see here on this picture. As for the nuclear physics, so we have the very long traditions in the Mössbauer studies here in Kazan University. We are one of the leading scientific group in this field, and in the end of this month, we will organize the international conference on the Mössbauer spectroscopy here in Kazan. And I would like to mention about one of the last publications in the Nature about the coherent gamma ray spectroscopy, which was developed here in Kazan University. In the field of space and astrophysics, we have very good collaboration with the different scientific groups. We have very good infrastructure to do this one. We have the very good results in experimental astronomy as well as in the fundamental problem of space. We are working very close with Professor Starobinsky, who are working now in Kazan University with our young researchers, just to looking for the new ideas in the dark matter and so on. For the experimental observatory, we have unique set of observation sites for the teaching and research studies. I have already mentioned about the three observatories, just one nearby the Kazan. Also, I would like to say that we have our own planetarium. We are only one university in Russia which has our own planetarium. All other planetariums belong to some government, some local government, and so on. But for the university, we have only one planetarium. And few weeks ago, we had the visit of the very famous cosmonaut Alexei Leonov, who was the first man who went to the open space, and he visited this planetarium and agreed to this planetarium will be given the name by the Alexei Leonov. We have the unique facilities, Mega Tartara. So this is a set of telescope in the North Caucasus, and I would like to mention that last June, this set of telescope found for the first time some gamma burst, and probably it was a burst from the burning from the burst of black hole, some black hole. So now the research is continuing, and we don't know exactly, but our Mega Tartara facilities was the first facilities who checked and who found this gamma burst in the world. Of course, we have the very good facilities for the observation in Antalya, in Turkey. We were a little bit frustrated about the last political events, but hopefully now everything is okay. Now we can work together in our laboratories. Here you can see some achievements which was made by using our telescope in Turkey, in Antalya. Okay. And for the space technologies, we do a lot for the new equipment, for new devices. And we have joint centers and joint laboratories with the leading companies which produced the unique equipment and for the scientific research as well as for the education. For example, we have the very famous center of our university with the Keysight company, the another one with the Rohde & Schwarz company, in which we provided the research development diagnosis of antenna system. We created some new smart antenna and new devices in order to develop new communication system. And we have laboratory for the national instruments devices as well. So we are interested not only in the fundamental physics, but for the creation of new equipment and for the new devices as well. And if we look for the investigations of medical biologic system by the physical method, of course, first of all, this is the investigations made by the different types of the magnetic resonance techniques. This is a nuclear magnetic resonance, electron paramagnetic resonance, so optics, lasers, and so on. We have the very good facilities here, but what we are interested in collaboration maybe with the Institute in Dubna for the proton therapy, for the hadron therapy, and so on, because we have no such facilities here. And again, the same center of magnetic resonance, and they're working also for this field as well. They try to determine the structure determination of biologic active peptides and so on. And here you can see the open lab structures which are involved to our investigations. Actually, this is some of these labs exist in the Institute of Physics, some of these exist in the Institute of Fundamental Medicine, and the open lab with Rick can exist in the Institute of Chemistry. And also, we, in the framework of this Center of Magnetic Resonance, we are very much interested in development of new approaches, new techniques and technology based on the NMR spectroscopy. Just to mention, so we are working with our oil companies in order to create new NMR tools to characterize porosity and permeability properties of the oil reservoirs using the nuclear magnetic resonance data. We have, so this is just characterizations of our unique equipment, which now introduced to every companies in Tatarstan and hopefully in Russia. So we have developed new mobile NMR tool in order to investigate the core from the Earth just in the field in order to characterize core samples just after extracting them from the Earth. So laboratory for ceramics, when we try to transfer our knowledge in physics and fundamental physics in order to create new bricks just for the constructing of new buildings. So this is just our transfer of our technologies. Okay, so I have no too much time, unfortunately. I can speak a lot about the research. I can see now the, our colleagues from the Institute of Physics in this hall who can explain in details the all things about which I have mentioned, about which I have not mentioned because I had not enough time, but nevertheless, we are very interested in the fundamental physics, in the experimental and theoretical physics, and the, in the applications of our fundamental results to the real practice and to the real education process. Thank you very much for your attention.